Hello friends and welcome to my channel M Square Analysis Projects. In today's video we are going to see linear and nonlinear analysis. So let's get started. First of all, understand what is mean by stress strain curve. So stress strain curve for this normally steel we have drawn here. So on this y-axis there will be stress, on the x-axis there will be strain. So initially stress increases, strain also increases linearly up to this point, that is a yield point. So this is a linear graph. So when it stress changes beyond this point, there will be plastic deformation, means body will not regain its original position when stress is removed. So this type of stress strain graph is found out from the ultimate tensile testing, that is UTM testing. Now for all the materials this graph is available by using that testing. So the portion inside this region, this is linear, and when there is a plastic deformation starts, this portion is called as a non-linear. Okay, so linear means when we see a line which is having a equation y is equal to mx, where m is the slope of that line, so this is a linear graph. But in case of non-linear, there will be an equation which is followed by this line, so then this equation is called as a, this curve is called as a non-linear. So let's see about linear and non-linear. So we will understand what is the difference between linear and non-linear. So linear curve is like this. So some materials have initially linear curve, or some materials have this non-linear curve, that is stress strain curve. So here this is a curve which is drawn for force, and this is for the deformation. As the force increases, then its deformation also increases. Okay, so it is derived from this stress strain graph itself. So the when there is a linear analysis, so what we will do, we will find out first line which is followed by this material, means linear graph. So we will prepare the equation, force is equal to stiffness into deformation. Here K will behave as a slope of that line, that is the K matrix, okay, stiffness matrix. And if we want to solve the non-linear problem, so material is behaving like this, means increase in the force will increase drastically in the deformation. So what is the steps to find out this non-linear analysis? We have to find out the equation for the non-linear problem, means this equation we have to find out so that we will get a curve. And it is a very tedious task, means it is very difficult to find out at each point how this curve is behaving. So there is no real repeatability, means in this curve there will be no repeatability in the non-linear analysis. So it is one more drawback, we can say. So no commercial software which is producing such type of non-linear curves for the material, particular material, and not in practical approach in the industry. So in industry also there is a we don't use a non-linear analysis. So these are the some reasons why we don't go for this non-linear problems. So the key points we can see, if we solve any problem which is non-linear in nature by linear problem method, then we will get an error. Means if your problem is a non-linear and we will solve it by linear method, then there will be error like this. So at this force, this linear will give some deformation, but non-linear curve will give some deformation. So there is a difference between these two. So that is the error. Okay. Second, there is no system in the universe is a linear. Means most of the problems, they have material properties like that. So they will behave as a non-linear, due to impurities, due to the load increase, due to some defects in the material. So they behave as non-linear instead of linear. Means theoretically it is behaving as a linear, but actually in practice they will behave as a non-linear. But in industry what happens, doing the non-linear analysis requires more time. We require equations of the curves, so that is impossible to get many times. So then what happens in industry, they will do this non-linear analysis by using linear method, and they will reduce the error acceptance. Means in industry 70-80% analysis are done linear, providing that error is 3% is acceptable. Means this type of error is there, so that error, if it is less than a 3%, then it is acceptable that linear analysis is correct. So this is the practical approach and the difference between linear and non-linear analysis. So we will go to the non-linear analysis. Means what actually happens in the non-linear analysis. Suppose we are having two graphs, one is linear, another is a non-linear. So at the load of, that is the force of 1000 Newton, we will get some deformation here, we will get some deformation here, that is the difference. So we want to go for non-linear analysis so that we will get an accurate result. So first step is reduce the full load, means we will reduce this 1000 load into 100, then 200, 300, like this. And what we will do, we will gradually increase to the full load. Means first of all we will do the analysis for 100, then we will do for 200, 300, like this we will go. So here solve a series of linear problems. So we will see what analysis will do. First of all, it will consider as a one line which is having one stiffness, that is K1. Then at this point, this stiffness matrix is reduced to another stiffness matrix, that is K2, means according to non-linearity. So another line which is having stiffness, that is K2. After this point, means 100, 200 and at a 300 level, so again this stiffness is reduced to, as per the conditions of non-linear, to K3. So likewise we are reducing, and every time we will reduce the slope or change the slope so that we will get which is closer to the non-linear analysis. Means this type of non-linear analysis, it is not solved by 1000 Newton. It is divided into 10 steps, that is 100, 200, 300 up to 1000, and each point we will find out a new stiffness matrix and we will solve this step only as a linearly. So it is a series of linear problems. So here solve this series of a linear problem. So this process is called as a sub-steps or sub-stepping. This is available in the ANSYS software to give the sub-steps. Okay. So accepted here how we do sub-stepping, that is 3% of error we will reduce. Means for this problem, suppose here, so this is a 3% error which can be accepted. So at this point we will get one sub-step. So next point we will somewhere here, we will, so error between non-linear and linear will be 3%, so that is accepted for this sub-stepping. Now what is mean by tangent modulus? So TM, it is tangent modulus, means this we have to define, this curve we have to define in the analysis software. Means what it will do, first of all it will take Young's modulus. Okay, so we will get a linear graph. So at this point we will define a tangent modulus, means again it will change according to that tangent modulus. Means slope of this is tangent modulus, here it is a E. So likewise we have to define a material so that curve becomes a non-linear. So this is how we will use non-linear analysis to solve a problem. Thank you for watching.